Hello and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on Raoult's law and vapor pressure. Raoult's law says that the vapor pressure of an ideal solution is dependent on the vapor pressure of each chemical component and the mole fraction of that component in the solution. So the addition of a non-volatile solute to a pure solution decreases the vapor pressure of the solution. And this is directly related to the relative numbers of solvent molecules to solute particles. So if you add a non-volatile solute to a solution, that non-volatile solute will essentially have no vapor pressure, but you're decreasing the vapor pressure of the pure solution because Raoult's law says that the vapor pressure is dependent on the vapor pressure of each chemical component and the mole fraction of that component. So by adding a solute to the solution, you're decreasing the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution. And so if you have a non-volatile solute in a solution, the vapor pressure of the solution is equal to the vapor pressure of the pure solvent multiplied by the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution. Because remember, the non-volatile solute has essentially no vapor pressure. And in this equation, X sub A is the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution. P sub A naught is the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. And P sub A is the new vapor pressure of the solution. What is the vapor pressure of water above a solution comprised of 3.4 grams of NaCl dissolved in 30 grams of H2O at 25 degrees Celsius if the vapor pressure of pure water at this temperature is 23.8 torr? Remember that in this equation, X sub A is the mole fraction of the solvent. So that would be the moles of H2O, which is the solvent, divided by the total moles of all the particles. Now I say total moles of particles here instead of total moles of NaCl because remember that NaCl is an ionic compound and in water ionizes to form sodium ions and chlorine ions. So for every one molecule of NaCl, we actually have two different particles of NaCl. So we need to know how many moles of H2O we have divided by how many moles of everything total that we have. And we're going to count each mole of NaCl as 2 moles of particle because it dissolves to give us 2 ions. So to calculate the number of moles of H2O, we take the number of grams of H2O that we're given. We use the molar mass of H2O. This allows us to cancel out grams, giving us 1.67 moles of H2O. To then calculate moles of NaCl, we start with 3.4 grams of NaCl. And convert to moles using the molar mass, which allows us to cancel out units of grams. And then we take into consideration that each mole of NaCl ionizes to form 2 moles of particles. So we have 0.166 moles of particles. So to calculate the mole fraction of the solvent, we take the moles of H2O, 1.67 moles, divided by the total number of moles of all the particles. So we add up the moles of H2O and also the moles of solute particles dissolved to give us 1.79 moles total. So the mole fraction of water in this solution is 0.933. We can then multiply this by the vapor pressure of the pure solution, which is given to us in the problem, 23.8 torr. And this gives us the new vapor pressure of the solution, 22.2 torr. Let's try a trickier problem. Calculate the grams of glucose, C6H12O6, that must be added to 2.85 kilograms of H2O at 65 degrees Celsius to lower the vapor pressure by 10 torr if the vapor pressure of pure H2O at this temperature is 188 torr. What we're going to do is to use the vapor pressure of the pure solvent and the vapor pressure of the solution to calculate the necessary mole fraction of water in the solution to give us this vapor pressure. So we know that the vapor pressure of the pure solvent is 188 torr. And we know that we want to decrease the vapor pressure by 10 torr. So we want the vapor pressure of the solution to be 178 torr. So now we can calculate what this mole fraction needs to be. And if you put these numbers in your calculator, you'll come up with a mole fraction of 0.947. And this is the mole fraction of water in this solution. So remember that the mole fraction is equal to the moles of H2O divided by the total number of moles. We don't know the total number of moles that must be added, but we do know that we have 2.85 kilograms of H2O, so we can calculate the moles of H2O in this solution. We use the molar mass to convert from grams to moles, so that means that we first need to convert kilograms to grams so that we can use the molar mass to convert to moles. We know that there are 1,000 grams in every 1 kilogram, and this allows us to cancel units of kilograms, and we know that the molar mass of H2O is 18 grams per mole. This allows us to cancel out grams, and we're left with 158 moles of H2O. We can plug this number into our equation to calculate the total number of moles in the solution. And so if you use this equation and solve for the total number of moles, you'll come up with 167 moles. Now the moles of glucose must be equal to the total number of moles minus the moles of H2O. So the total number of moles are 167 moles minus the moles of H2O or 158 moles means that we need 9 moles of glucose in the solution. But we're asked to calculate the grams of glucose. Now you will notice that in the previous problem I talked about moles of particles. In that case, we had an ionic compound that ionized in water to form two different particles. In this case, we're working with glucose, which is a molecular compound. When glucose dissolves in water, it does not ionize. Going back to calculate grams for moles, we need to use the molar mass of glucose, which is 180 grams of glucose per every mole of glucose. This allows us to cancel out units of moles, and tells us that we would need 1.62 times 10 to the third grams of glucose to be added to 2.85 kilograms of water at 65 degrees Celsius to lower the vapor pressure by 10 torr. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.